जय गोपी जाना वल्लभा गिरिवर धारी जय गोपी जाना वल्लभा गिरिवर धारी यशोदा नंदन व्रज जन रंजन यशोदा नंदन व्रज जन रंजन जमुना तीरा वनचारी जमुना तीरा वनचारी जयो राधा माधव कुंज विहारी जयो राधा माधव कुंज विहारी जय गोपी जन वल्लभा गिरिवर धारी यशोदा नंदन व्रज जन रंजन यशोदा नंदन व्रज जन रंजन जमुना तीरा वनचारी जमुना तीरा वनचारी हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्णा हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्णा हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे जय राधा गोपीनाथ राधा गोपीनाथ राधे जय गौरनिताय 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 जय गौरनिताय जय श्री गोपाल श्री गोपाल जय श्री गोपाल जय जय प्रभुपाद 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 प्रभुपाद
जयं विष्णुपाद परमहंस परिव्रजकाचार्य अष्टोत्तरशत श्रीमदभयचरणारविंद भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय अनंत कोटि वैष्णववृंद की जय नामाचार्य श्रील हरिदास ठाकुर की जय प्रेम से कहो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासित गौर भक्तवृंद की जय गौर प्रेमानंदे हरि हरि बोल गौर प्रेमानंदे हरि हरि बोल ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। नारायणं नमस्कृत्यं नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वती व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरयेत्। नष्टप्रायेषु अभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया। भागवते उत्तम श्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिकी। कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय देवकी नंदनाय च नंदगोपकुमाराय गोविंदाय नमो नमः। रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद्भागवतम 12th कैंटो चैप्टर 5 वर्स 4 पर्पोट्स एंड ट्रांसलेशंस आर गिवन बाय द डिसिपल्स ऑफ हिज डिवाइन ग्रेस एससी भक्तिवेदांत स्वामी श्रील प्रभुपाद। वर्स नंबर 4 स्वप्ने यथा शिरश्छेदम पंचत्वादि आत्मनः स्वयं यस्मात् पश्यति देहस्य तत आत्मा हि अजो अमरः। स्वप्ने यथा शिरश्छेदम पंचत्वादि आत्मनः स्वयं यस्मात् पश्यति देहस्य तत आत्मा हि अजो अमरः। स्वप्ने यथा शिरश्छेदम पञ्चत्वाद्यात्मनः स्वयं यस्मात् पश्यति देहस्य तत आत्मा हि अजो अमरः। स्वप्ने यथा शिरश्छेदम पञ्चत्वाद्यात्मनस्वयं यस्मात् पश्यति देहस्य तत आत्मा हि अजो अमरः। स्वप्ने यथा शिरश्छेदम पञ्चत्वाद्यात्मनः स्वयं यस्मात् पश्यति देहस्य तत आत्मा हि अजो अमरः। स्वप्ने यथा शिरश्छेदम पञ्चत्वादि आत्मना स्वयं यस्मात् पश्यति देहस्य ततो आत्मा यजो अमरः। वर्ड टू वर्ड मीनिंग स्वप्ने इन ए ड्रीम यथा इज शिरः ऑफ वन्स हेड छेदम द कटिंग अप पंचत्वादि द कंडीशन ऑफ बीइंग कंपोज ऑफ द फाइव मेटेरियल एलिमेंट्स एंड अदर मेटेरियल कंडीशंस। आत्मनः वन्स ओन स्वयं वन सेल्फ यस्मात् बिकज पश्यति वन सीज देहस्य ऑफ द बॉडी ततः देयरफॉर आत्मा द सोल ही सर्टनली अजह अनबर्न अमरह इमोर्टल ट्रांसलेशन इन ए ड्रीम वन कैन सी हिज ओन हेड बीइंग कट अप एंड दस अंडरस्टैंड दैट हिज एक्चुअल सेल्फ इज स्टैंडिंग अपार्ट फ्रॉम द ड्रीम एक्सपीरियंस सिमिलरली व्हाइल अवेक वन कैन सी दैट हिज बॉडी इज ए प्रोडक्ट ऑफ द फाइव मेटेरियल एलिमेंट्स देयरफॉर इट इज टू बी अंडरस्टूड दैट द एक्चुअल सेल्फ द सोल इज डिस्टिंक्ट फ्रॉम द बॉडी इट ऑब्जर्व्स एंड इज अनबॉर्न एंड इमोर्टल वर्स 5 घटे भिन्ने घटकास आकाश स्याज यथा पुरा एवं देहे मृते जीवो ब्रह्म संपद्यते पुनः ट्रांसलेशन When a pot is broken, the portion of sky within the pot remains at the element sky, just as before. In the same way, when the gross and subtle bodies die, the living entity within resumes his spiritual identity. Verse 6. Mana sujati vaidehan gunan karmani chatmana tan mana sujate maya tato jivasya sansruti hi. Translation. The material bodies, qualities, and activities of the spirit soul are created by the material mind. That mind is itself created by the illusory potency of the Supreme Lord. And thus, the soul assumes material existence. Verse 7. Srihadhisthana vartyagni sanjoga yavatiyate तावदीपस्य दीपत्वं एवं देहकृतो भवः रजसत्वतमवृत्त्या जायते अथ विनश्यति ट्रांसलेशन ए लैम्प फंक्शंस एज सच ओनली बाय द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ इट्स फ्यूएल वेसल विक एंड फायर सिमिलरली मटेरियल लाइफ बेस्ड ऑन द सोल्स आइडेंटिफिकेशन विद द बॉडी इज डेवलप्ड एंड डिस्ट्रॉयड बाय द वर्किंग्स ऑफ मटेरियल goodness, passion, and ignorance, which are the constituents, elements of the body. Verse 8. Na tatratma svayam jyoti javyakti avyaktayo paraha akasa iva chadharo dhuva ananta upamastataha. The soul within the body is self-luminous and separate from the visible gross body and invisible subtle body. It remains at the fixed basis of changing bodily existence. Just as the ethereal sky is the unchanging background of material transformation, therefore the soul is endless and without material comparison. Verse 9. Evam atmanam atmastam atmani आत्मनि एव अमृष प्रभो बुद्ध्यानुमान गर्भिण्या वासुदेव अनुचिंतया माय डियर किंग बाय कॉन्स्टेंटली मेडिटेटिंग अपॉन द सुप्रीम लॉर्ड वासुदेव एंड बाय अप्लाइंग क्लियर एंड लॉजिकल इंटेलिजेंस यू शुड केयरफुली कंसीडर योर ट्रू सेल्फ एंड हाउ इट इज सिचुएटेड विद इन द मेटेरियल बॉडी वर्स 10 चोदित विप्र वाक्येन न त्वाम दक्षन्ति तक्षक मृतभ्यो न उपदक्षती मृत्युना मृत्यु ईश्वर ट्रांसलेशन द स्नेक बार तक्षक सेंड बाय द कर्स ऑफ द ब्राह्मण विल नॉट बर्न योर ट्रू सेल्फ द एजेंट्स ऑफ डेथ विल नेवर बर्न सच ए मास्टर ऑफ द सेल्फ एज यू फॉर यू हैव ऑलरेडी कंकर्ड ऑल डेंजर्स ऑन योर पाथ बैक टू गॉड हेड परपट रियल डेथ इज द कवरिंग ऑफ वंस eternal Krishna consciousness. For the soul, material illusion is just like death. But Parikshit Maharaj had already destroyed all those dangers that threaten one's spiritual life, such as lust, envy, and fear. Sukadeva Goswami here congratulates the great saintly king, who, as a pure devotee of Lord Krishna, homeward bound to the spiritual sky, was far beyond the reach of death. ओम अज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजनशलाकाय चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन त तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः श्री चैतन्य मनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूप कदा मह्यं ददान्ति स्वपदान्तिकं वन्देहं श्रीगुरु श्रीयुत पदकमलं श्रीगुरुन् वैष्णवाश्च श्रीरूपं शाग्रजातं सहगण रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं सद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादान् सहगण ललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितांश्च हे कृष्ण करुणा सिन्धु दीनबन्धु जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिकान्त श्रीराधाकान्त नमस्तुते तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिये वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले शिवते भक्ति वेदांत स्वामिनिति नामिने नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देशतारिणे जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। तमादिदेवं करुणानिधानं समालबन्नं सुहितावतारं अपार संसार समुद्र सेतु भजामहे कृष्ण भागवतम स्वरूपम। हरे कृष्ण। आई सीक द ब्लेसिंग्स ऑफ ऑल द डिवोटीज सो दैट आई कैन स्पीक समथिंग मीनिंगफुल फॉर द प्लेजर ऑफ द डिवोटीज एंड फॉर माय प्यूरिफिकेशन। Verse number 10, translation, the snake bird Takshak sent by the curse of the Brahmanas will not burn your true self. The agent of death will never burn such a master of the self as you. For you have already conquered all dangers on your path back to Godhead. Purport, real death is the covering of one's eternal Krishna consciousness. For the soul, material illusion is just like death, but Parikshit Maharaj had already destroyed all those dangers that threaten one's spiritual life, such as lust, envy, and fear. Sukadeva Goswami here congratulates the great saintly king who, as a pure devotee of the Lord, homeward bound to the spiritual sky, was far beyond the reach of death. So, karmis, they desire to enjoy in this material world. It said that runam krutva grutam pivet jab tak jivet sukham jivet bhasmi bhutasya dehasya kutah punam agavanam bhavet. If you do not have money, then you beg, borrow or steal, but enjoy life like king says and drink ghee. That was the mood of the karmis. But the gyanis, they think that this world is miserable. So, they want to get out of this material world. Bhaktas, they accept it as the desire of the Lord. If Krishna desires, then we'll stay in this material world. And if he does not like, then we'll go to the Vaikuntha world and we'll serve there. That is the desire of the devotees. So, once upon a time, one of the disciples of Buddha, Lord Buddha, he is telling to Buddha that I want to go for a tour. The Lord Buddha asks, you know how much struggle you have to face? You will go out, then somebody will abuse you. Somebody will throw you stone. Somebody will beat you with the sticks. Somebody will kill you with a sword. Then this disciple is telling that, okay, if somebody is abusing me, then I'll think that, okay, he's not throwing me stones. If somebody is throwing me a stone, then I'll think that it's better that he is not beating with a stick. If somebody is beating with a stick, then I'll think that, okay, he's not removing my neck from my head. And if somebody is trying to remove my head, then I'll think that, okay, it's better that I'm not committing suicide. And the other thing is that, anyway, this life is miserable. At the old age, I have to go through a lot of pain. Better to leave this burden now only. Then Buddha is telling them, okay, now you can leave this place and you can go on a tour. But devotees, they are on the higher platform. So once upon a time, Ananta Acharya, he was flocking the tulsi leaves at Tirupati to make the garland for their lordship. So he was being beaten by a cobra. And his disciples were watching. Guru Maharaj, you do something. You at least consult a doctor. Take some medicine. But he is not hearing. Then all the disciples, they approached Lord Balaji and prayed to Lord Balaji, please do something for our Guru Maharaj. Lord Balaji personally comes and asks Anantacharya, you do something now, you may die. Then Anantacharya telling, so what kind of snake you are telling about? There is a cobra which is there in my heart, which is biting me every time with pride, greed, and all the things. But if my being a snake, if my poison is powerful than that cobra who has bitten me, then I will not die. But if that cobra is powerful than my poison, then I will die. But that does not matter. If I'll die, then I will go to Vaikuntha world and serve you there. But if I will not die, then I will serve here, I will continue my service here. So there is no problem. So then the my swarupa is Jivara Swarupa Hai Krishna Nityadas. So this is my swarupa. And I will continue my service to you eternally. That's why King Kulasuka says, Idam Shariram Parinamo Pesalam Patanti Avasyam Shata Sandhi Jarjaram Kim Aushadham Pruchhasi Mudha Durmate Niramayam Niramayam Krishna Rasayanam Pivet. Idam Shariram Parinamo Pesalam. This body is anyway going to destroy. See, what kind of medicine you are searching for? See, the only medicine for this body is, soul is, to chant the holy name of the Lord. So devotees of the Lord they are not fearful. Narayana parasarve na kutaschana vivati. Swarga apavarga narkesu api tulyartha kaschana. So devotees of the Lord, whether one kind of people are there, shishnodara parayana, whose only goal of their life is to maintain their belly and genitals. And others are the devotees, Vasudeva parayana, Narayana parayana. So Narayana Parayana devotees, they are not fearful of anything because they are clear that does not matter whether I am here or Swarga or Narka. My only service is to render devotional service to the Lord. So that's why they are not fearful of the upcomings, of the obstacles of the world. So we'll see all those philosophies what we have heard in these 7-8 verses in the pastimes of Jadavarata. So once upon a time, the king of Sindhu and Sauvira, Rahuvana, he was going to meet Kapila Muni, to Kapilasram. So he was being carried by a palan queen. Four people were carrying. But in between, one of the carrier, he got ill. So they were searching for a carrier who can help them out. And they found that this Jadavarata, he was sitting on Virasan, and they found that he was very strong, strength also, he was looking like a bull. So this is the best person who can help us. So they forcefully brought him and engaged him in their service. Although Jadavarata, he was a great sadhu, it's like fire covered by us. although he was a great sadhu, he, from the external people, he was invisible. So they brought him, they engaged him in their service. So, but while walking, he would see 3 feet away and then he would walk. So while doing that, this palanquin was shaking. So, so sadhu drishti means here is, you can see that sadhu, being a sadhu, when he was engaged in a menial work, he didn't chastise that, he accepted that service happily. But while rendering service, he was not forgetting that I am sadhu, I should not kill any ants or any insects. He was conscious of that. So being in conscious of that while carrying the palanquin, it is there is an imbalance of the frequency, so that the palanquin was shaking in between. So in that condition, the king asked, walk properly. Then in that condition, these people are telling that, you are O Naradeva, you are the king of these people. You should know that we are working properly, but this person who is newly appointed, he is not working properly. So that is the nature of this material world. So the people who are in the mode of the, in the passion, they always try their own sukha and dukha. They do not think about the other's sukha and dukha. The people who are in the mode of goodness, they think about the other's sukha and dukha. But the people who are in sattva guna, they think about the sukha and dukha of the other people and the Lord also. So here, these people, they started blaming that the person who is newly appointed, that person is not working properly. Like, you know, small story. Once upon a time, one farmer, so one master, he engaged some people to remove the weeds from the paddy field. So many people came in between them. Amongst them, one blind person was there. So everybody was engaged to remove the weeds. And in the evening, the master came and saw that the weeds are not removed properly. Then he asked, who cleaned this area? Because they found that their weeds are there. So everybody tells that this blind person he has removed. And who cleaned this area? A blind person. Who cleaned that area? Blind person. Everybody is blaming that blind person. So then the master is telling that, okay, everybody is done by the blind person. I will pay to the blind person only. I will not to pay to all of you. So like that here, they are blaming this, Jadavarata. Or one more thing is that, see, Jadavarata was in the mode of goodness and others are in the mode of, the carriers are all the, in the mode of ignorance. The king, because he was doing the job of the passion, he was in the mode of mixed mode of passion and goodness, because he was going to the Kapila Ashram to take instruction from him. So many modes are involved in this. Mode of Saudhsudha Sattva, mode of goodness, mode of passion, and mode of ignorance. So when we try to do any service with all these mixing modes, it's very difficult to do that service properly. So that is why there are many family breaks because modes are not matching. So in this condition, the sadhu, what he does, he preaches to the others and bring them up, uplift them, bring them to the mode of goodness and engage them in the sadhu, in their service. But in many cases, it's not possible to uplift them. So in that condition, sadhu has to go down. Otherwise, we can't do the service. Because, for example, we always try to be in the temple, we also always try to be in the mode of goodness. Try, at least. We don't want to be angry, but sometimes it is the need. We have to become angry. For example, when this lockdown started in March, then it continued. We thought that 15 days, 1 month, after 1.5 months, it will be done. So, but after, in the month of April, there is a big filter, that water treatment plant near to our Egyas Tilip area. We renew all those filters every 4 months. It was due in the month of April. But because of this lockdown, that person was unable to come. So again, in the month of May, some things started working. Some shops started working. So we requested that person, you come and do the needful. She telling that, no, I can't come because my shop is not open. Many excuses. Every day I'll call, I'll tell you tomorrow. I'll check and tell you tomorrow. It continued for many days. This kind of people, srunmanatvi, no srunoti. Ekan mein dalke, dusre kan mein nikala rahega. Unka kaam hi sab. So we requested, in many, it continued up to 15 days. Then the rain came in the month of June. So then I was concerned about the health of the devotees because filters are not renewed. With that, the multi-part port valve of the sand filter, that was also damaged. So mostly it was unfiltered, properly unfiltered water was coming. So I was trying to do my best. I was trying to call these people again and again, again and again, but no response from them side. Again, after a few days, they stopped their mobile only. So we had no option only. So we went through the net and we found some options. One dealer was there in Ahmedabad, and during that a parcel courier service was stopped. So we will not be able to get that item. And we, after following for 3-4 days, we searching for the 3-4 days, we got one company near at Dahisar. We contacted that person, and what we found that multi-part valve is different from that our multi-part valve. So we decided that, okay, we'll go for the modification of the plant. We brought all these items. Gorillas who helped me to send the vehicle. We got all the multi-part valve and these filters. We renewed the filters and changed the multi-part valve. And filters started working properly. So doing that, thing is that if you want to be in the mode of goodness, then it's very difficult to render the services. Okay, I can remain in the mode of goodness, but with that, many devotees, many people will suffer. So in that condition, we need to go down, come down to the material mode of passion and work with these people to make the work done. So here, this Sattva Guna, Raja Guna, Tama Guna, and Rasuda Sattva, all of them are fighting. So in this condition, Rahuvana is thinking, okay, this person is not working properly, and I am telling him if I remove this person, what will happen? I may not get a replacement. So if I allow him to do like this, then other people, they will be act like this, and they may throw me in that Sindhu river. So here he thinking that I have to punish him. I have to rule him. So in that condition, he telling that in this condition, Rahuvana becomes little angry because of this sansargika dosa, because in the mode of passion, because he is doing the duty of the king, he becomes little angry. And he chastised us, why are you not working properly? So he is using some sarcastic words like, I think you are very tired. You are very old, very diseased. You have carrying the carrier alone, I think so. And you have walked very long distance. That's why I think you are very tired. So although he is using all these words, but he is not disturbed at all. Jadavarti is not disturbed at all. Although he was criticized by the king. So because he was in the Brahmabhuta state, Brahmabhuta Prasanatma, na sochati na kankhyati, sama sarveshu bhuteshu madbhakti labhayatapara. He is neither lamenting for anything, nor hankering for anything. He is seeing everybody equally. So So Rahuvana is in Dehavandhana, but Bharata, he was out of the bodily concept of life. He was in the mode of that na hanyate hanimani sharira. He knew that very well, that if I am being killed, my body is killed, I am not going to be killed. Fully detached from the body. So Prabhupada writes that asangahi ayam purusha. Although he is there in this world, he is detached from this world. Although he is there in this body, he is detached from the body. So I'll give you one example. So it is the day of DT installation of Radha Vrindavan Vihari at GEV. That day I was given the service of the plate washing. So some devotees were there to cooperate with me, to help me. So on that day I was doing the plate washing service, and we were cleaning the pots, plates with hot water from the boiler. So in between there was no need of hot water, so one devotee, he closed that outlet valve, but somebody had fed firewoods in that boiler. So because of that, what happened, the temperature increased, and that because the outside pipe was plastic pipe, the pipe burst. The devotee who was in charge of the maintenance department, he came and asked me, do you know what is boiler? So that day I was disturbed, fully disturbed. Although it was a great function, I was fully disturbed because I was in such a bodily concept of life. Because for me, that is not even counted as a boiler. Because I was working in a ship whose output was 550 pounds discharge pressure and temperature are 850 degree Fahrenheit. So almost all the machineries used to move only by the steam. So for me, it was not a boiler at all. So, but he told me that, do you know what is a boiler? That word was impinging me, piercing my heart, like so much that I was unable to concentrate my mind on that day. But that was not the fault of the devotee. But I was such in a body, I was in such a bodily concept of life, I was unable to digest that. So that is the condition, bodily concept of life. But here, this Jada Bharat, he continued carrying the palanquin. So after a few minutes, the Rahuvana saw that there is no chance in Jada Bharat. Then again he said that, oh, you are like a Jivan Murta, although life is there in your heart, but you look like dead, Jivan Murta. You know, I am the king, I can rule you. I am like the Yamaraj, I can punish you. So, all the things when he spoke, still Rahuvan was, king was, Jadavarat was not disturbed at all. Another thing, while I was in this shipbuilding sector, Visakhapatnam, once upon a time, and it's near about 9 o'clock, my officer, senior officer, he was searching for one file. And I told, he was not getting that file. It is early morning, 9 o'clock. I told one of my junior, okay, you can find that file in that cupboard. He suddenly became angry and he told me that, Mishra, what do you know? You are useless fellow, guy, get out from here. I also became little, immediately I also got little angry. I told him, sir, mind your language. So he became so furious that then he told to my senior, Mahasab, I want to see him in dress number 8S. Because there are many dresses in Navy. 8S, 8, 10, 10S, the numbers are there. So that is, he wanted to give me some punishment. So I was thinking, actually during that time I was in confusion, what should I do? Whether I should continue my service or should give up my job and join the ashram. So I consulted many devotees and my counselor was Haridasa Guru. He told me that, what do you want, If I serve for another 5 years, I'll get some pension. No, Prabhuji told me that, what do you think? Radha Gopinath needs there your pension? Still, my diet was not clear. All my relatives were telling that you continue or go for another 5 years after pension, you can join the ashram. So I was in that concern. So, but that day, my room was near 4 or 5 kilometers away from the office, and my senior told me that, okay, officer wants you to see you in that rig, you go and change your comment, go and meet him. So I went to my room, and while on the way, I was thinking, what is the need to serve these selfish people? If I'll continue to serve these selfish people, they'll behave me like this. Because in my tenure, in my 10 years of service, Navy, whatever service I was given, I did that service happily, faithfully. So that word was piercing my heart. And I went to my room, offered my obeisances to Radha Gopinath in the photo form, and prayed, please help me. Because he can put me in that condition, because I used that word now, he can put me in more, give me more punishment also. So I was fearful. So I prayed and came to meet that person. Whatever he said, I tolerated. And that day only decided I will not continue the service. I'll join the ashram. So, then Bharat Maharaj, he thinking that this person is offending me, I will give him jnana and uplift him. So first time he's opening his mouth. He never opened his mouth before that. So this is the first time he's opening his mouth, and he's telling that, oh, you told me that Parishanta, I am very, very tired. But I am not tired. Whatever you said, that is true. But my body may be tired. I am detached from my body. So I am not tired at all. So when somebody is attached to the body, he thinks that this body is all in all for me. For example, one of my friends was there. He used to sleep, he cannot sleep without fan. Even if the temperature is 5 degrees, he needs that fan. He will cover his body with that blanket, and he needs that fan because he is addicted to that fan. That sound, he is addicted to that sound. So that is called Dehabhyasa. Similarly, because we have stayed in this body for thousands of years, we have developed attachment to this body. And that is called Dehabhyasa. So here he's telling that, I am not attached to the body, I am detached from the body. Whatever you said, that you told that I am strong and stout, all the things, everything is connected to the body. But me being a soul, I am fully detached from this. So Prabhupada writes, na deha smati nahi jaro, sansara bandhana kahan tar. If somebody is detached from the body, how he can be bound in this sansara? Although Rahugana knew that Atma Tattva, still here Jadavarta wants to give that realization of that Atma Tattva, because Rahugana used to hear from Kapila Muni. He had that knowledge, theoretical knowledge, but here Jadavarta wants to give that realization of Atma Tattva. Then he tells, you told me that Jivanamrita. Jivanamrita means, although I am here in this body, I am dead, but this body is temporary. Jatasya dhruva mrityu dhruva janma mrityasya cha tasmat aparihariyarthe natam sachitu maharaj. If somebody has taken a birth, he has to die. So this body is temporary. Like Hiranyakashipu, he is teaching when Hiranyaksha was dead, and Hiranyakasipu's wife, they are crying. Here, Hiranyakasipu is giving instruction to the wives of Hiranyaksha. And in that, he quote the one story of how Yamaraja comes and teaches the queens of Suyagya. And here the sentence comes as yatragatas tatragatam. He telling that how amazing it is. These persons who are older than me have full experience that hundreds and thousands of living entities have taken birth and died. Thus, they should understand that they also are apt to die, yet still they are bewildered. The conditioned soul comes from an unknown place and returns after death to that same unknown place. There is no exception to this rule, which is conducted by material nature. Knowing this, why do they uselessly lament? So this body is temporary, our soul is eternal, and I am not in this bodily concept of life. So whatever you told is not true. Then you told that I am Swami, and means you are Swami and I am your servant. Okay. Karmana daiva netrana jantur deha upabhidyate. According to your karma, now you are king and I am your praja. But next time it can happen that you can become my praja and I can become your raja. So this is temporary. You should not be proud of this. So this post is given to us to render services, to discipline us. So once upon a time, there is some argument happening between the temple president and the manager. And both of them approached to Prabhupada. And Prabhupada telling that, see, you are doing this duty as a service. The manager post and president post, it is a service given to you. So you are only Krishna is the manager. You are not the manager, you are the servant. So here in ISKCON, everybody is Krishna Das. Only Krishna is the manager. So nobody should be attached to the post. So in Parikrit Maharaj asked Bali, asked to Sukadeva Goswami, why Bali Maharaj was bound? So Sukadeva Goswami is telling that this is fault of the Bali, that Lokanam Api Ishwara. Bali told that I am the Prabhu of the people, I am the Lord of the people. That's why Lord Vamandev bound Bali Maharaj. So that post Krishna does not like. So the only post of the living entity is that Jivara Swarupa Hoy Krishna Ra Nitya Das. Again, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu tell that Gopi Bhartur Pada Kamarar Das Das Anudas. Still the king is telling that, okay, follow my order till I am the king. Then Raghavan is telling, who is the controller and who is controlled? So I am a Abadhuta, I am detached from the body, whatever your instructions are not to for me, for my body. For example, an actor, sometimes actor, when he wears a dress of the king, he thinks himself as the king. So there is no need to become proud of this. Then Raghavan is telling that, I will do your chikitsa, pramatasya chikitsa. I will do your treatment. Then Jadabharata is telling that chikitsa can be only for the body. So I am not the body. So whatever chikitsa you can do. So he is telling that today, still now, many people tried to do my chikitsa. My parents tried to do my chikitsa. Even the doctors tried. Even many my brothers tried to do my chikitsa. But nobody was able to do my chikitsa. But chikitsa can be done only by the, chikitsa can be done only for the soul. That's why Prabhupada has opened many Atma Chikitsa Kendras ISKCON, Atma Chikitsa Kendra ISKCON, where the chikitsa treatment of the soul can be done. So Jadabharata is telling that, okay, you told me that Unmata, if you are thinking that I am Unmata, I am a mad person, so if you try to rule me, what will happen? If you try to rule a mad person, what will happen? That mad person will become more mad. For example, nowadays, in our childhood, teachers used to beat us if we do something wrong. And nowadays, it can happen. Teachers cannot beat the children, students. Because if they will beat, they will become more unmata. So that's why, if you punish a mad man, he will become more mad. So there is no need to do the treatment of the unmata person. So all these statements penetrated the heart of King Raghuvana. Vidyate hrudaya granthis chidyante sarva sansaya. So all this, all his doubts are slowly and slowly getting destroyed. And Jadavarta continued his service of carrying the palanquin. He thinking that I have prarabdha. Although he was a great paramahansa, he thinking that I am having prarabdha. Like that, Narsingadev Bhagavan, he wanted Prahlad to rule the world. But Prahlad Maharaj was not interested. So Narsingadev will tell him, you have prarabdha, you have to serve. Because na bhogena punyam kusalena papam, he is using that slogan. So similarly, here he thinking that although he had no prarabdha, still he thinking that I have prarabdha, I have to serve. So in this condition, Rahugana is telling that wait, and he is telling that you keep the palanquin on the ground. He gets up from the palanquin and offer obeisances to Jadavarat. So sradhavan lavate jnanam, because he was eager, all this knowledge was penetrated in his heart, and he stood, offered obeisances to Jadavarat. And Jadavarat started, because he was in close proximity of the sadhu, all his sansara bhaya is destroyed, and bhajana vighna, that is also destroyed. The king is speaking, I think you are Kapila Muni. Who are you? You are in this dress, invisible, you are in Abhyakta Linga, you are Yogeshwara, you are a great yogi, and I am unable to know you. Who are you? Are you Dattatreya? Are you Kapila Muni? You please tell me. He said, no, I am just a carrier. So he is getting disturbed. Then he offers obeisances to king. King is offering obeisances to Jadavarat. And he is praying this prathana. Naham vishanke suraraja vajran na taikshasula na yamasya dandat nagniyarkasama nila vitapastra sanke vrusham brahma kulavananat. Then he is telling that I am not fearful of the thunderbolt of the Indra. I am not fearful of Yamaraj's danda. I am not fearful of the trident of the Lord Shiva. But I am fearful of offense. So I have committed a great offense. Please help me. So seeing that, Jadavarta thinks that he has, now he is a proper person to whom I can give this knowledge. So he gives this knowledge in chapter 18, 11. About this tattva jnana, because he was qualified. After giving this tattva jnana, he is telling that rahugana deta tapasa na jati na ijaya nirvapana gruhadva na chandasa naiva jalagni sure vina mahatpadara jo bhishekam rahugana deta tapasa. This tattva tattva will not get by austerities or worship of deities or taking sannyasa, but by spearing the dust particle of the devotees. So one teacher was telling that three times reading is equal to one time writing. Three times writing is equal to one time understanding. Three times understanding is equal to one time making others to understand. Three times making others to understand is equal to one time applying or doing that thing. And three times doing that thing personally equal to one time making others to understand. It's very difficult to teach others, give the Atma Tattva Jnana. That's why it is very difficult to make the devotees. So here that can be possible only by Sadhu Krupa. So here, because of the mercy of Jadavarata, Rahugana become a great devotee and gives up his life and goes to the forest and practices devotional service. So only why he gave Krupa to the dacoits who came to kill him. Because he prayed to the deity that, Devi, you please give your darshan to them. he helped his brothers by giving them continuous darshan. But here, he gives his krupa by giving the Atma Tattva Gyan. So I'll complete this in 1-2 minutes. When Nala Kubera and Madigreva was delivered, and they offered prayers to Lord Damodar. Vanim gunanu kathane shavanam kathadau hastascha karma samanastava padayona smrutyasirastava nivasa jagat praname drushtim satan darshanastu bhavatanuna. So here Nala Kubera and Manigrama both are asking all the things only for the Lord. Vanim gunanu kathane, let our speech speak about you. Tongue, speak about you. Bailing gunanu kathane, shavanam kathadau, let our ears hear about your pastimes. Shavanam kathadau, hastasya karmas, let our hands be engaged in your service. Hastasya karmas, manas tava padayana, our mind be engaged in your, at your lotus feet. Then, smritya siras tava pad, tava nivasa jagatvana, and let our head offer obeisance to all the things in this material world. Because Lord is available each and everything in the form of Paramatma. He is asking, both of them are asking everything for the Lord. They are asking but one thing for the devotees. Drushtim satam dasane arthu bhavatanuna. So they are asking that, but let us get the darshan of the your devotees. Then Lord Damodar is asking, what happened to you? You are asking everything for me. You don't like my Damodar form? So people, they meditate my this Damodar form throughout their life. Even the devotees, they worship me in the month of Kartik, throughout the month. You don't like this form? Then Nala Kubera and Manigrava, they are telling that actually it's not like that, like liking or unliking. Think that because of the mercy of a devotee, Narada Muni, we got your darshan. We are in the mode of Kamandha and Dhanandha. But Narada Muni saw us. Narada Muni used to go to Indra's palace. Indra would worship him every day. But Narada Muni never showered his mercy to Indra. But that day, he showered, he gave one glance to us. Because of that, we got your darshan. Without our desire. But if we see him as a devotee, what kind of blessings we will get? So that's why we need the, to we are desiring to see the beautiful form of your devotees. So devotees are more merciful than the Lord. So here Jadabharata is showering his mercy to all the people. So thank you so much. Hare Krishna. Granthara Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai, Srila Prabhupada ki jai.